Hi, this is Bennett Tchaikovsky, and today we're going to talk about how to look up financial statements using SEC.gov. This date of the presentation is Friday, October 26, 2018. Really quickly, my disclaimer and copyright notice, the information and opinions in this presentation are those of the author only and not the author's employers or affiliated organizations, including, but not limited to, Irvine Valley College, the South Orange County Community College District, or Chapman University. The presentation is for educational purposes only and does not constitute any legal or accounting advice whatsoever. This presentation is copyright 2018 by myself, Bennett Tchaikovsky. I want to really encourage you to share this presentation and share links to the presentation on an unmodified basis. If you want to modify the presentation in any way, please reach out to me via email to discuss. Note here, I am not claiming any copyright whatsoever in any companies or organizations mentioned in this presentation. Rather, these other parties are the owners of their respective copyrights. So, what is the Securities and Exchange Commission, or SEC.gov? It is not the Southeastern Conference. Rather, all publicly traded companies are required to file their financial statements with the Securities and Exchange Commission. And there's a lot of other information that they need to be filing as well. But we're going to be starting here with, essentially the basic financial filings. And what are these filings really used for? Part of the reason why these filings are being made is that we want to make sure that a publicly traded company is complying with what we call Reg FD, or full and fair disclosure. If I'm telling one person financial information, I want to tell the world. Why? Because then I would be engaging in what we call selective disclosure, and that person receiving that information could then take it and do things such as insider trade or trade on the information. Note here, if you're a huge fan of In-N-Out, Uber, or Lyft, as of the date of this presentation, those companies are not publicly traded. And so you would not find that information on the Securities and Exchange website, because this only governs publicly traded companies. Okay, so what we're going to look at first is how do we look up a publicly traded company on SEC.gov and download their financial statements on Microsoft Excel. So we're going to go first. Hold on. Sorry about that. What we're going to do here, let's go back to this. What we're going to do here is we're going to go to SEC.gov. And when we get to SEC.gov, there is a lot of information. This is an amazing website. I really encourage you to spend some time on it. There's a lot of information here. And you can see here under enforcement, they've got litigation releases, administrative proceedings. And if you want to see, do accountants get in trouble? Yes. Do attorneys get in trouble? Sure. Do companies get in trouble? Yes. And this is where you can find that information. So what we're going to do is we're looking here for the filings of publicly traded companies. So we're going to go right here to this button where it says company filings. And when we get to company filings, I have two different options. I can essentially either do this by the company name, or I can do what we call a fast search. And just for fun, we're want to look up Amazon. So let's look up Amazon. So when I look up Amazon, I get all these different ones. And wow, just a lot of different things that have Amazon in there. I could probably guess that the Amazon I want is going to be this one. But really, to make sure, let's go back here. What I want to do is to look up the ticker symbol for Amazon. So how am I going to do that? What I'm going to do is I'm going to go on Google. I'm going to type Amazon ticker symbol. And guess what's going to pop out? The Amazon ticker symbol. When we see this NASDAQ, essentially AMZN, this is essentially the exchange that it's trading on, which is the NASDAQ. There's also the New York Stock Exchange. And AMZN is what we know as their ticker symbol. So I come over here to Fast Search. I type in Amazon, and I'm going to come up here. And what this is going to do is this is going to give me all of the filings of Amazon. And going back here, what we want to though really do is we want to download the financial statements of Amazon onto an Excel spreadsheet so we can go through and take a look at those numbers a little bit more in depth. But we have two different types of reports. There's a, for financial statements at least, there is a 10K, which is what we call an annual report. It is not a race, but it is called a 10K, it's called a Form 10K, which is the company's annual report. And then there is a 10Q, which is a quarterly report. So let's go over here and we'll start with, we're going to do take a look at the 10Q. But if I want to look at the 10K, what I can do is to kind of narrow this down because there are so many different filings. I just type in 10K and voila, only the 10Ks will be popping up. So when I go to 10K, and we're going to look at this here that was filed on February 2nd, 2018. I'm going to first go over here to documents. And when I go to documents, I'm going to see a lot of information. But the information that I want, at least to kind of see the financial statements, is going to be here, which is a very long document. And as we can see right here, Amazon Form 10K, a lot of information in here. And if I want to go through and kind of jump ahead and take a look at the financial statements, what I'm going to do is I can kind of jump here to say financial statements and summary data. And when I do that, I'm going to actually see the audited report, which came from Ernst & Young. And then I'm going to go ahead and see the financial statements. Now, I could copy and paste this onto an Excel spreadsheet, but that might get kind of crazy. So what I'm going to be doing instead is, let's go back out of this. If I want to download the financial statements of this particular period, I'm going to go to this button that says interactive data. I'm going to press on that button. And what this is going to do is this is going to take me here to all this various different information. It's going to show financial statements, statements of cash flows, statements of income, and operations. And one of the great things about one of the, this is all courtesy of what we call XBRL, is that we can actually download these in Microsoft Excel. So I can either print it or I can view an Excel document, and let's kind of see what happens. It may jump off my screen, but as you can see right down here, hopefully you might be able to see this. And when I open up that file, again, I'm not sure if it's showing up on your screen or not. We'll see what happens. Let's see what goes on here. This is a little bit of an older Mac. Apple, if you want to send me a new one, I'll give you some shout out and some love. Okay, right over here. So I come over and I look here at the, this is, I'm not sure if you're able to see this or not, but this is essentially the Excel file that's coming up as a result of that. So that's how I go through and download a statement on Microsoft Excel. Then I can go through and manipulate that data. I can upload that data onto a Google Sheet. Google Sheets has a very easy way in terms of uploading that data. It will save all the tabs and everything else. Huge believer in the Google Sheets. So that is a kind of a brief overview in terms of how to go through and look at that Excel document. One other thing I want to just make you aware of, and this is a site that I haven't visited in a while, and I actually know one of the owners of it, but it's called Contexia, and I'm probably saying that name wrong, but what this site does is it goes through and it essentially will compare filings of companies period over period. So if a company is changing its disclosure in terms of the way that they're showing, say if it's a product composition or something else along those lines, this is a product that goes through and analyzes this. And I want to encourage you just to take a look at it because it is a very interesting product. Okay. Now to kind of continue on with the presentation, and what I wanted to do is just to give you, when you're looking at this SEC website, you're going to see a lot of different forms and filings. And I just wanted to give you more of a kind of a summary in terms of what each of these mean. The Form 10-K is a company's audited annual report showing the full year results. The 10-Q is a company's quarterly report, and they're going to have that for the 3, 6, and 9 months ended. Very importantly, the quarterly reports are not audited by the auditor. So Ernst & Young will audit the financial statements of Amazon annually. However, when it comes to the reviews, they're going to use much more limited procedures. So when you see a 10-Q, the numbers, you know, they're management's numbers. However, the auditors have not performed a full-blown, they have not audited those numbers, and there's a very big difference. So, and then when I look at definitive 14A, and this is what we call a proxy statement. And generally, if a company is listed on the NASDAQ or New York Stock Exchange, by default, they are required to have an annual meeting. And at that annual meeting, they generally ratify auditors or appoint new auditors, increase the number of shares. There might be a variety of different things that the shareholders will be voting on. Another one is something called a Form 20-F. What is 20-F? It indicates it's a foreign filer. So when you look up a company such as Alibaba, you will not see a Form 10-K. Rather, you'll see a Form 20-F because they are a foreign issuer that is listing their shares here in the United States. Form 6-K is similar to a Form 10-Q, can be also be used. Let me repeat this. Form 6-K is used for a variety of purposes by foreign filers. One of the things that the company will do is they'll show some information that you could find on a quarterly report on that Form 6-K. One of the other parts here is when it comes here to registration statements. What is a registration statement? Well, when a company goes public and wants to issue shares and sell them publicly, they have to register those shares. And so this involves what we call a Form S-1. It's a very long form, much longer than the 10-K because it's going to include additional disclosures for investors. A Form S-3 is sometimes called a shelf registration. This is if a publicly traded company has been around for a while, if it meets certain requirements. What the S-3 is used for is to essentially resell either shares purchased or to just, you know, register shares and sell them as they would like to sell them. And again, these are really, when you're looking at how a company is raising funds, this is really one of the ways they're going to be doing it is by selling their own stock or, you know, other kind of borrowings. So that's really what a Form S-3 is. A Form S-8 is used to register shares for employee stock plans. And Form 424B3 updates prior prospectuses. So again, these are just different types of filings. If you want to know more about them, I've included a link in the back of this presentation, which I'll show you where to find. And what other types of filings are there? There's Forms 3, 4, and 5. These are used to reflect management or board members' acquisitions, disposition of company securities. 144, if somebody owns stock that is not on a registration statement, then they're going to use 144 to sell those shares. Form 13G is used when an owner is going through and reporting their ownership interest. Generally, if owners own more, if one person or a group owns more, has a controlling interest in more than 5% of a company, that has to be filed or notified with the Securities and Exchange Commission. And oftentimes you will see investors only owning up to 4.99%. And why is that? is because they don't want to have their share information reported or their share ownership to be publicly available. Now, the other part of filings is what you'll see is Form 8K, and you'll find this one pretty frequently. This is, again, what companies use to ensure that they're really complying with that Reg FD or that full and fair disclosure. And there's a variety of different, you know, Form 8K items. There's 1.01, which is the entry into a material agreement. In fact, there's like 1.01, 1.02, but these are the ones that I've kind of seen more commonly. Results of financial operations and condition generally will be filed when the quarterly is filed. Notice of delisting, if a company fails to meet the standards of, say, the NASDAQ or the NYSE, it'll be subject to delisting. Change in company's auditors, departure, appointment of officers and directors, Reg FD disclosure, and then other events. And going back to Alibaba, Alibaba will use the Form 6K not only to show their quarterly report, but also to go through and make other informational disclosures as well. Now, where can you find my presentation and this one and other ones that I've made? Is that where you can find it? Is that if you go to ibc.edu. And when you go to ibc.edu, you will go to faculty and staff. You will then go to faculty websites. And then you'll look up myself, Mike Wazowski, and Bennett Tchaikovsky. And you will find this presentation as well as a variety of other presentations down here. And lastly, here are the various different links I've used in the presentation. Bridget Yuli, and I'm probably saying her name wrong, so Bridget, I'm sorry for that, but she wrote a great article in terms of some of the, you know, what do you need to know in terms of SEC filings, Investopedia, great website. So I want to thank you for joining me today on this presentation, and please feel free to email me, and you can do that through my faculty website at IBC if you have any questions. So thank you again for joining me today on this brief presentation of how to look up financial statements at sec.gov.